what can cause two identical fields to produce different yields despite being farmed the same way for 50 years. In this episode, we'll hear from North Dakota farmer Joe Breker about how history can leave a lasting impact on your soil's health and its ability to produce quality yields.
There's a lot of research out there about soil health and a ton of technical information, but none of it does us any good unless we can see how it actually takes place at the ground level. My name is Tim Hammerich from the Future of Agriculture podcast. Cool Planet and I are going to travel the country and capture stories about how land stewards and growers and farmers are actually developing their own soil health and how that impacts their lives and the food they're growing for you.
This week's episode takes us to Rutland, North Dakota, where I met up with Joe Breker of Breker Farms.
We're out here because we want to learn more about kind of how you look at soil health and your journey into trying to improve your soil. Could you just tell us about how you view the soil here? Maybe a little bit of background on the soil and how you view yourself as the steward of this land.
I'm a fourth generation farmer on this farm place. A lot of things had happened in those prior three generations to degrade the soil. The soil had been worked with tillage for 80 years before that I came on scene farming it in the late 70s. It was noticeable, and my dad lived through the 1930s, the Dust Bowl days. He saw land blow away terribly. Mm-hmm. So in his mind, there had to be a better way to farm. So when I heard of a concept of no-till farming, I investigated it further. He supported me. And in 1979, we had our first no-till field, and by 1980, we were all no-till.
So we're gonna get a chance to see today what it looks like after 40 years of no-till. But just to set the stage a little bit, what would look different if you hadn't done that?
When I took over most of the land I'm farming today, it was at 3.5 to 4% organic matter. Most of that land today, if I'd have been tilling the last 40 years, would be at 2.5 to 3.5% organic matter. With no tilling and then the last 20 years using cover crops, I've been able to bring those organic matters up a full 2% across the farm.
Joe, tell us about this field here that's right behind us.
It's an 80-acre soybean field. Last year I did a nitrogen rate study in corn in here where I had different nitrogen rates stripped north to south. On the lower nitrogen rates, there was as much as 50 bushels difference in the corn between the north 40 and the south 40. And the difference is the historical practices that were done on this land. I think one was probably kept in grass during the 30s and didn't erode. The north one eroded significantly, and my dad remembers that because he grew up right next to it. For 50 years or more, it's been farmed the same, north and south. Huh. Fertilized the same, north and south. Same crop rotation. It's been one field for the last 50 years at least. But yet, it shows differences in the crops it raises from the north 40 to the south 40 every year.
Wow.
Even though it's been farmed no-till, there's still a difference. Now, the organic matters on this north 40 are getting pretty good again.
Yeah.
And the general soil health looks good. If you put a shovel in there, I mean, it looks good.
Yeah.
But I know it's not as good as the field that didn't have that severe erosion on it.
Because of something that happened 80 years ago.
Because of something that happened 80 to 120, 30 years ago.
That's unbelievable. Once you lose it, I mean, it is.
You can't ever bring it back.
In general, conservation is very important to farmers, but you specifically seem like it's a really, really deeply ingrained belief. Where does that come from for you?
I thoroughly believe that everybody has an opportunity to farm in a more conservation manner, mm-hmm. from a soil health aspect. Everybody can do it. They just gotta figure out how it works for them.